strongly says something, you just have to pay attention and take it seriously. I don't think you have to take their recommendations what to do seriously. I'm an amateur paleontologist, and many years ago, before I decided to do public life, I thought I'd be either a zoo director or a vertebrate paleontologist. The planet has changed temperature patterns off and on for the entire history of the planet. I was recently, Chris and I were at the Field Museum in Chicago, which is a great institution, and we were looking at dinosaurs from Antarctica. Now, if you think about it, that would suggest that the planet was rather warmer than it is right now. I think you have to look at all of these factors. There's no evidence that there were either automobiles or electric generating facilities during the ancient dinosaurs. So, on the other hand, there were other factors that probably led to a higher temperature. My personal hunch is that we're going to discover that solar radiation is the largest single component of whether or not temperatures change. The other point I just make to all of you is the planet changes all the time. I mean, I knew Al Gore when his number one fear was nuclear winter. This is what in the mid-1980s, the left all of a sudden became panic-stricken because a total exchange of nuclear weapons between Russia and the United States would throw enough dust up, you would create nuclear winter, and agriculture would die off, and we'd be in a tremendous crisis. And I've always thought that Gore invented global warming as a way of melting nuclear winter.